गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी स्टडी अबाउट द एनामलस स्ट्रक्चर इन डायकॉट स्टेम. एग्जाम्पल इज बोराविया स्टेम. द ट्रांसवर सेक्शन थ्रू द स्टेम ऑफ बोराविया शोज मोर आर लेस सर्कुलर आउटलाइन. And its primary structure shows epidermis, cortex, endodermis, pericycle, and vascular bundles. Epidermis, it is single layered with cuticle. The cells are filled with violet sap. A large number of multicellular hairs arise from the epidermis, and epidermis also have the stomata. Cortex is many cells in thickness. It may be differentiated into two different regions, the outer hypodermis containing polenchymatous cells and inner chlorenchymatous cells or parenchymatous cells. A few layers of polenchyma form the hypodermis. It is followed by loosely arranged parenchyma with intercellular spaces. The cells of this region contain chloroplast. Then endodermis. It consists of a single layer of cells separating the cortex from the vascular tissue. Casparian thickenings are absent in the cells of endodermis. Then pericycle. One or two layers of parenchyma below the endodermis forms the pericycle. Isolated patches of sclerenchyma occur in the pericycle. Then the vascular tissue. The primary vasculature of the stem consists of number of vascular bundles embedded in the ground tissue in three rings. This is the characteristic features of the Boravia stem, means the presence of vascular bundles in three rings. The innermost ring consists of only two fairly large bundles facing each other, situated in the pith. Hence they are called medullary bundles. Each bundle is conjoined, collateral, open and endarch. These two vascular bundles lie opposite each other and are the largest of the bundles. Xylem in both the bundles is towards the center of the stem and phloem towards the periphery. The bundles are oval in shape. The second or middle ring consists of 6 to 14 vascular bundles. These bundles are smaller than those of the innermost ring. The bundles are conjoined, collateral, open and enlarged. This ring also occurs in the pith, and hence the bundles are also called medullary vascular bundles. The third or outermost ring consists of a large number, that is up to 15 to 20 much smaller bundles occurring just below the pericycle. Phloem fibers are absent in phloem. Embedded in the hard lignified conjunctive tissue means the vascular bundles of the outermost third ring remain embedded in the lignified conjunctive tissue. The inner two rings of the bundles are medullary, while the outermost ring is normal. This is an anomaly in contradiction to the presence of a single ring of vascular bundles in dicot. Generally, in dicot, there is only a single ring of vascular bundles, but in Boravia, the vascular bundles are arranged in three rings. This is the anomalous structure. Then the secondary growth, how takes place in Boravia? The secondary growth in thickness in the inner two rings of vascular bundles is due to the activity of only fascicular cambium. Secondary growth here is confined to the individual vascular bundle. In the third or outermost ring, the fascicular cambia joins with the interfascicular cambial strip to form a complete ring. These cambial cells form secondary xylem towards the inner side and secondary phloem towards the outside in the fascicular region only. In the interfascicular region, these cambial cells form lignified conjunctive tissue towards the inner side and parenchyma cells towards the outside. The activity of this cambium soon declines and a new cambial ring rises in the parenchyma outside the secondary phloem or in the cells of pericycle. This cambium is called the extraspinal cambium. It produces secondary growth as in the previous ring of cambium. That is, in this manner, a few cambial rings may arise outside, producing a few growth rings. The newly formed bundles remain embedded in the hard lignified conjunctive tissue. The secondary bundles contain scanty phloem opposite secondary xylem. Cork cambium or phyllogen arise in the hypodermal colenchyma. This cork cambium gives rise to cork or phyllem on the outer side and secondary cortex or phyllodur on the inner side. The cork cambium and secondary cortex together constitute the peridur. The anomalous characters of Boravia are in primary anatomy. The vascular bundles are arranged in three rings. And secondary anomalies, the cambium ring formed during secondary growth produces secondary xylem and secondary phloem in the region of fascicular cambium only, while in the region of interfascicular cambium, it gives rise to thick-walled lignified conjunctive tissue on inner side and thin-walled storage parenchyma on the outside. 4 to 5 successive rings of cambium go on developing in the outer storage parenchyma region and functions in the same way. These cambial rings give rise to successive rings of collateral vascular bundles embedded in the conjunctive tissue. This is all about the anomalous structure of Boravia stem. The anomalous structure is presence of 3 rings of vascular bundles. The innermost ring, that is first ring, it contains only 2 vascular bundles which are bigger in size as compared to the vascular bundles of second ring and third ring. The vascular bundles in the second ring, they are smaller than the rings, vascular bundles in the first ring. They are up to 6 to 14 in number. They are also present in the fifth region. That's why the vascular bundles of first ring and second ring, they are called medullary vascular bundles. While the vascular bundles which are present in the third ring, they are smaller in size and they range from 15 to 20 in number, and they remain embedded in a lignified conjunctive tissue. And in the secondary growth takes place in two inner rings of vascular bundle confined to only fascicular region, while the secondary growth in third ring takes place by the conjunct joining of fascicular cambium with interfascicular cambium and forming a ring. And in fascicular region, it develops secondary xylem towards inner side and secondary phloem towards outside. While in interfascicular region, it forms lignified conjunctive tissue towards inner side and simple parenchymatous storage tissue towards the outside of the interfascicular region of the ring. This is the anomalous secondary structure of Borravia stem. Thank you.